How big was it for you to get out of that?
Oh, it was huge. And honestly, I'm having trouble like remembering where we are in the lineup because I just try to pitch to the batter and do my best stuff. But Karen and Annie and the rest of the defense are so good about reminding me and knowing like what the situation is. So just go out there and pitch in my game, and defense is doing their job.
Swafford really had your number tonight. She came out with the home run and then the triple. How did you kind of calm yourself down after she had those two big plays?
Just breathing, really. Slowing things down mentally and knowing that what I have is good. I mean, she was the only one that had my number. So that's the way I had to look at it. And that's the biggest batter I have to face in the lineup next to Hugo, who I had her number all night. So that's the only way, is just slow things down, pitch my game.
Karen Weekly says you kind of separate your hitting and your batting. How do you manage to do that and not let the two intersect?
Hitting and pitching, you mean?
Yeah, hitting and pitching. So.
Well, it's definitely a mindset. You know, you just go out there and dominate in the circle and then come in, celebrate with the rest of the team, and then you reset yourself. And I just start focusing in on the other pitcher and getting my timing down as soon as I come in the dugout. And I still cheer for my teammates as well, but I just do it mentally, focus, slow things down all the time.
What part of your game were you the most proud of tonight? Because you were pretty good in both categories.
I would have to say pitching right now. I've been struggling a lot lately, and to come out and pitch a good five innings was huge, not just for me, but for the rest of my team, so we can all have that confidence, and the rest of our staff as well, too.
Tomorrow you are kind of trying to go for the sweep over Georgia. How important is it to, you know, still remain focused and not be complacent and just settle for, you know, the series win?
Oh, it's huge. And that's one of the hardest things about winning the first two games is teams can become complacent. But if we keep playing our game and being relentless and just stay on this high and keep going after them and focusing on the small things, then we'll do our job and we'll get it done.
It seems like both these kind of games had the same theme of you guys had some shaky defense early and then come back with a late offensive surge. What do you credit that to?
I just credit to our mental game and pitching staff. When we get errors on the field, we still go at them and we trust our defense the next time and the next time and the next time. And that's huge for the circle, because once we have that confidence in our defense, they're going to build off of it too. And we know we're going to get our bats going at some point in the game no matter what. And I would say it's all the mental toughness that we have gained throughout the year.
And then just the differences in it, too. Last night it was, or I guess yesterday afternoon, it was the home runs that, you know, got you guys back in it. Well, today, I mean, you got hit by a pitch. There was a sack bunt in there, a couple more walks. You know, it looked like you guys, I guess, were just being more patient?
I would say so. Once we got a hold on Chelsea, the first pitcher, Gray, she started mixing the corners a little more instead of letting them fat. So we had to be a little more patient but still stay aggressive. And we just focused on having long at-bats and staying long through the ball and seeing it a lot more. So that built up a lot of more confidence. And then we didn't fish for anything. You know, we knew they were getting shaky and the pressure was on, and we still played our game at the plate.
Georgia's a team that you have, you know, the opportunity to see in Oklahoma, you know, in late May. What's it like, you know, playing a team like that, winning the series, and possibly getting the sweep tomorrow?
It's huge, but at this point, we've seen it. You've seen it all on the SEC Network. It's anybody's game any day, no matter what you're ranked. And we just got to keep playing the same game, same toughness, same aggressive relentlessness, and the mental aggressiveness that we have. If we come out there every day, every time we compete against these SEC teams and any team we play, we're going to be really, really well.